Okay, good day. So we are done with our lesson 1, the state object. Lesson 2, the statements, expressions, and order of precedence. We are moving on to topic 3, the arithmetic operators. So up to topic 5, topic 4, the formatting outputs and the mathematical functions library. So what are the learning outcomes? At the end of this lesson, students should be able to use of arithmetic operators in any creation of mathematical expressions with emphasis on operator precedence. So understand and use of type conversion, type casting, and using library functions that work with numbers and use proper formatting methods throughout the program, and apply and demonstrate the technical concepts and knowledge acquired from the previous lessons in our subject C++. So, topic 3, arithmetic operators. So, what is operators? Operators is very rich in built-in operators. So, operators in C++ are mostly made of signs that are not part of the alphabet, but in available in all keyboards. So, operator is a symbol that instructs C++ to perform some operation or action on one or more operand. So, an operand is something that an operator acts. So, in short term, in simplest term, operators are used to perform operations on variables and values. So, ang C++ is rich in built-in operators na nagpo-provide ng following these following types of operator: unary, binary, and the tertiary. So, unary is one operand, the binary is two operands, and the tertiary is three operands. Also, this group of operators is built-in in C++. So, the arithmetic operators, it is used to perform common mathematical operations. The assignment operators is used to assign values to variables. For example, int x is equal to 10. So, ang comparison operators naman is used to compose two values. Logical operators naman is used to determine logic between various variables or value. So, bitwise is bit by bit. Bit by performs bits by bits operation. So, yan lang. So, these are the fundamental arithmetic operators of C++. Yung operator niya, common naman, plus, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and the yung percentage sign is the modulus. So, these are all binary in terms of types. So, let us elaborate the operators. So, assume that A holds 10 and the B holds 20. So, in addition, it adds two operands. So, A plus B will give 30. So, subtraction naman subtracts second operand from the first. So, A minus B will give negative 10. So, bakit negative 10? Kasi yung second operand is sinubstract sa first, and it's because yung sa order ng precedence natin. Yeah. So, multiplies both operands. A times B, 10 times 20 will give you 200. So, divides numerator by the denominator. So, B divided by A will give 2, or 20 divided by 10 will give 2. So, modulus operator and remainder. Now, modulus operator and remainder of A after an integer division. So, modulus is the remainder of the operator of the integer. So, B modulus A will give 0 because 20 modulus 10 will give you 2. So, there's no remainder kaya 0 ang sagot niya. So, the increment operator naman is yung plus plus, or yung A plus plus will give 11 because an increment operator will increase one integer value by 1. So, the decrement operator naman decreases integer value by 1. So, a minus minus will give you 9. So let's have a sample. Sorry, the question mark. So let's have a sample program. So hindi ko na siya i-type sa DevC kasi may problema yung DevC. Explain ko na lang siya dito. So ang assignment operator, sabi ko nga kanina, is assign values to variable. Example is x is equals to 10. So observe nyo itong sample program na to. Observe how x was not affected by the final modification of y. Even though we declared x is equals to y earlier. This is because yung sa order ng precedence natin is right to left rule. Kasi ang assignment, ang order ng precedence ng assignment is right to left rule and never the other way. So, see out x colon. So, sinial niya yung x column first. And then, see out x. So, the value na sinial niya sa x is the value ng 4. Why? Because x is equals to y. So, y is equals to 4. So, ang order ng precedence niya is pa taas. So, na-read ni compiler si x is equals to y first, tapos si y is equals to 4. About sa see out y, colon, see out y is equals to 7. Why 7? Eh, bakit si x 4 yung sinihaw niya kasi y is equals to 4? Kasi nga, sa order of precedence is right to left. So, nauna niyang nabasa si y na 7. Okay. So, ito kasi, sa compiler, sa x, dito sa x, dapat, kung nang nasa isip nyo, dapat 7 din ang nabasa nyo kasi sa right to left. No, kasi sa compiler, nabasa nyo na si x minus y. So, pataas na siya. Kasi right to left, so ito na yung mababasa nyo. Y is equals to 4. Okay? So, nag-gets po ba? So, yun siya. So, lagi nyo lang tatandaan yung order of precedence dito sa operators natin. Kung hindi nyo nga, tignan nyo yung table doon sa order of precedence, yung table. So, mathematical operators, we have the same class, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and then modulo or yung modulus. So, example, x plus y. So, assume x is 13 and y is 3. So, 13 plus 3 is equals to 16. X minus y, 13 minus 3 is equals to 10. X times y, 13 times 3 is equals to 39. And x divided by y, 13 divided by 3 is equals to 4. And x modulo y, 13 divided by 3 is equals to 1. So, modulo is the operation that gives the remainder of the division of two values. So, 13 divided by 3 is 4. So, 12. So, may remainder siyang 1. Okay? So, increment, decrement. So, explain natin yan sa sample program. Okay. So, this is the sample program. Nag-declare ka ng variable in x, y, may nag-declare ka ng x is equals to y is equals to 10. Mathematical assignment operator. So, see out backslash n x minus minus. So, x minus minus backslash tab. Kaya nandun siya sa katapat ni 10. Kasi nag-dibigay ka ng backslash t, minus minus y. So, the value of x is the value of y. And the value of x and y is equals to 10. So, see, x minus minus will give you 10 because ang unang na-read recompiler is yung x. Kaya hindi niya muna na minus kasi meron tayong prefix mode and postfix mode. So, prefix mode, si prefix mode, nauuna yung mathematical operator, which is yung plus-plus, and the postfix mode naman is nauuna yung variable doon sa mathematical operator. So, yeah. X minus minus or x decrement will give you 10 kasi una nyo na-read si 10. Si 10. Kasi si x or si 10. So, minus minus y. So, nauna yung na-read si mathematical operator or si decrement. Kaya, bumawas muna siya bago niya na-read si 9. Ay, si y or yung 10. Okay. So, x minus minus, since si 10 is nabawasan na, yun na yung marunit na value ngayon ng compiler natin. Kaya siya 9. So, x minus minus, so give you 9, minus minus y, so it will give the output of 8. So, x increment or x plus plus, so 8, hindi siya nag-plus kasi nga nauna nyo na rin si x, so 8. So, minus minus y, 8, na ngayon ang value na rin ng compiler, so 7 na lang yung value ni y ngayon. So, mama-minus niya kasi nauna niya na-read si minus, si that minus minus na si decrement. So on so forth. So, x plus plus, so it will give you 9, so minus minus y, 7, x plus plus, so plus plus y, x minus minus, and plus plus y. So on so forth. Ganun na siya. So, lagi nyo nang tatandaan yan, kung ano yung nauuna, yun yung unang i-relate ni compiler. Pero, depende yan sa order of precedence dun sa assignment operator. At dun sa order of precedence natin. So, sa compound assignment operators naman, it provide a shorthand method for combining a binary mathematical operation with an assignment operation. So, the syntax for compound assignment operators are a type sample. So, ang compound assignment niya is A times is equals to B. So, the expression niya, ito na yung expression is A is equals to A times B. So, example niya, 5 times is equals to 10, or ang solution niya is 5 is equals to 5 times 10 is equals to 50. So, pinaitli niya lang or pinasimply si incentizer, pinakompound niya yung operators. Ayan. So complex expressions naman is consist of sintier expression connected by the operator. So, 10 plus 5, an expression consisting of the sub-expressions 10 and 5 and the addition operator plus. So, let's proceed to sample. Example. So, if A, B is equals to 3, C is equals to 20, and D is equals to 10. So, you declare the operator A is equals to B, and A plus is equals to 2, B times is equals to C, and C divided by is equals to D. So, C out A. So, what will be the given value to A? So, A is equals to 3 plus 2. Kasi nag-declare ka dito. So, the value niya is 5. Kasi A is equals to B and B is equals to 3. So, A plus is equals to 2. So, it will give you 3 plus 2. The output will be 5. So, C out B. So, what is the value of B? B is equals to 3. So, B times is equals to C. C is equals to 10. 20, it will give you 60. Because ang expression yan is B is equals to 3 times 20. So, sa CLC naman, C is equals to 20 divided by T. C, ang magiging expression niya is C, is equals to 20 divided by 10. That will give you 2. Okay. So, let's proceed to formatting outputs. So, in formatting output, we can control how output displays for numeric and string data. So, we can control the size, the positions, the numbers, the numbers of digits. So, kapag mag-formatting tayo, nag-require tayo or nire-require ni C++, nag-gagamit tayo ng IO manip header file. So, si IO manip header file ay nagpo-provide ng parametric manipulators such as yung iOS natin, yung input-output stream. So, set iOS flags. Ano ba ba? Set reset iOS flag, set base, set fill, set precisions, and set width. So, yung format flag sa akin, tsaka yung set character natin, is nasa loob ni IOM header file. So, kung gagamit ka ng mga codes na set width, set precision, it requires na lalagyan mo siya ng IOM file. So, example. Sample niya. So, sample programs will display 3 rows of numbers. So, sharp include iostream, using namespace std, int main. So, declare variable int num1 is equals to. So, yan. Tingnan natin yung cout niya. Cout number 1, the value of 1. Number 2, the value of 2. So, yan siya. So, kung mapapansin nyo, hindi siya naka-perfect row. So, if lalagyan natin siya na stream manipulators, ano ba yung stream manipulators? Stream manipulators are used to control features of an output field. So, some affect just the next value displayed or yung set W, or yung value niya, and print the value in a field at least X space as well. So, tingnan natin yung sample kanina. Nalagyan natin siya ng iomanip header file. Ayun na siya. And sharp include iomanip header file. This, nare-required niya to yung set W. So, ayan na yung codes kanina. Int na, mas equals 297. Ayan. So, set, cout, set width. 6 num1 and set width, so maglalagay siya ng width ng 6 spaces after 6 spaces after. Okay, so hindi kasi siya makita yung pagkakaiba dito, pero pag connect nyo yan sa pag in-out sa perfect column na siya. So by printing each number in a field of 6 positions, they are displayed in 6 perfect columns and rows. So, dito kasi, minsan, ito mali kasi nga, print screen kaya dito. Ito kasi, nandito yung 7. So, hindi siya perfect row. So, if we use set W or set width, it will become a perfect column. So, sa set precision manipulators naman, at the slice set precision manipulator, when used with figs, print floating point value using exponents. After the decimal with a fix, print floating point value using executable. So, let's proceed to the sample program. So, syempre, kapag gagamit ka ng mga stream manipulators, don't forget na ilagay si header file, yung iomanip. So, declare the variable quotient. So, cout set precision to 5. Ibig sabihin, isi-set mo yung i-output niya ng 5 digits lang. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, cout set precision to 4. So, So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ah. 1, 2, 3, 4. So ang set precision is after the decimal point. 3, 2, 1. And yeah. Yan yung ibig sabihin ng set precision. I think I get so much. So the first value is displayed in line 7. So set precision to 3. 1, 2, 3. So so ito yung set precision table natin. So set precision to 5. Set precision to 4. To 2, 3, 5, 4. Okay. So when fixed, when the fixed manipulator, fixed is used to decimal notation, not in notation for floating point. For says the print digits is fixed point notation or as well. So let's proceed to this sample. So int double day 1, day 2, day 3, and the total. So cout enter the sales for day 1. So cout na yung enter the sales for day 1. So cin day 1. So magsisingin ka dito. Cout enter the sales for day 2. So kailangan din magsingin for day 2. And then enter the sales for day 3. And calculate the total. Total is equal to day 1 plus day 2 plus day 3. So, cout sales in figures. So, cout, cout. So, cout day 1, set with 2-8, kaya ang layo niya. Kung walang set with 2-8, magkadikit siya. Day 1, tapos nandito agad yung 1, 3, 2, 8. Yan agad siya. So, kaya set with 2-8, yan. Day 2, set with 2-8, day 3, and day 4. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Set with. So, the show point manipulator. So, tignan natin yan ha. Nung show point always print a decimal point for floating points values. This is useful with fixed and set precision when printing monetary values. So, by the default, floating point numbers are not displayed with trailing zeros. So double x is equals to 123.4, y is equals to 456.0. So cout set precision to 6. So anong magiging output niya? 6456.0. So kung lalagyan natin siya ng show point at ng set precision, at nag-set ka ng set precisions to 6. So, ang magiging output niya is, for example, itong y. C out y is equals to 456.000. Okay? Yan natin. So, the C out statements will produce the following output. Yan na yung output niya. Although 6 significant digits are specified for both numbers, kasi nag-set precision sign ng 6, neither number is displayed with trailing zeros. So, if you want the number spotted with trailing zeros, you must use the show point manipulator as shown in the following code. So, at ganito siya magiging code mo. Cout set precision to 6. Show point X and L. So, end line, cout Y, end line. So, this cout sequence will produce the following output. Kasi nag-set precision tayo to 6. So, ang magiging output niya is 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, nag-show point tayo, kaya nadagdagan siya ng 0. Kasi kung mapapansin nyo, ang z out statement niya lang talaga is 123.4, 123.4, and 456.0. So, nag-set precision ka ng 6 na nag-show point ka, kaya 6, yun lumabas. Lumabas yung trailing zeros niya na 2 para maging 6 yung precision niya. Okay? So, I think that gets naman. So, let's proceed to the left and right manipulators. So, the right justification of output value is in the field. So normally, output is right justified. So normally, yung output natin is nandito siya pala sa right. Kung napapansin nyo, diba? O yan, nasa right siya lagi. Nasa right. So, for example, look at the following input. So, display x 146.789, y is for 24.2, z. So, set with type of 10, x, y, z. See out natin yung x, y, z. So, each of the variables x, y, z is displayed in a print field of 10 spaces. So, the output of the cout statement is, so, nasa left side siya, 146, yan ang magiging output niya. So, notice that each value is right justified or aligned to the right of its print field. So, you can cause the values to be left justified by using the left manipulator as shown in the following code. So, kung pwede niyo yung code, kung pwede niyo ilagay dito siya sa left side. So, paano? Double x is equals to 147. So, declare mo yung variable. So, C out, left. Set with to 10 and set with to 10 x the value of x. So set with to 10 the value of y. So the output of this cout statement is nandito na yan sa set with to 10. So may 10 spaces between 10 spaces before siya. So magiging dito yung output niya. Gets po. So, nag-set with ko to 10. So, we have 10 spaces here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then, you declared left. So, nandito siya sa left side lahat. Okay. So, in this case, the numbers are aligned to the left or their print field. So, the left manipulator remains in effect until you use the right manipulator, which causes all subsequent output to the right justified. So, yung left manipulator remains in effect hanggang hindi mo din na-declare na mag-right justify ulit yung output. So, manipulator summary, string manipulator set with, it establish a print field of n spaces. Or yung value ng n, yun yung may sasabihin. So, sa fixed naman, it displays floating point numbers in fixed point notation. Show point, it causes a decimal point and trailing zeros to be displayed even if there is no fractional part. So, sa set precision naman, it sets the precision of floating point numbers. Left, sa right, it causes subsequent output to be right justified. Yung left naman, sorry naman. It causes subsequent output to be in left justified. So, topic 5, the mathematical library, functions. So, the cout routine library provides the several functions for performing complex mathematical operators. So, this requires CMAT header file. Kung kanina yung sa formatting natin, it requires the IOMANIT header file. Sa mathematical functions naman, it requires the CMAT header file. So, they take double arguments and return a double. So, let me share integer. So, abs are yung absolute value of the argument. So, it returns the absolute value of the argument. Yung cos, it returns the cosine of the argument. Exp or computes the exponential function of the argument. So, f mode. Yeah, as a double, the remainder of the first argument divided by the second argument. So, it works like the modulus operator. But, the arguments are doubles. So, sa lang naman, it returns the natural logarithm of the argument. Sa lang din, returns the base 10 logarithm of the argument. In sin, it returns the sin of the argument. SQRT or square root returns the square root of the argument. Tan or tangent returns the tangent of the argument. So, sample program of the mathematical operator. So, sharp include IO stream, IO manip, and CMAP. So, meron na tayong CMAP. This is for the IO manip, is for the set precision, and for the square root and power function. So, using the MSTD, it may double A, B, and C. So, C out, enter the length of the side A. C out, enter the length of side B. C and B. So, C is equals to square root power A 2.0 plus the power of B, which is 2.0. So, C out the length of the hypotenuse is C out set precision to 2, eto siya, and line. So, each of these functions is a simple to use as a power function. So, the following program segment demonstrates that square root functions, which returns the square root of the number. So, C in num, S is equal to square root num. So, C out the square root of num is S and 9. So, where is the output of the program segment? With 25 as the number entered by the user. Enter a number. So, 25. The square root of 25 is 5. So, for this issue, square root is function to find the hypotenuse of a right triangle. So, C is equal to A squared plus B squared. So, in formula, C is the length of the hypotenuse and B are the lengths of the other. So, by tayo dito, so, nag-enter siya ng side which is 5.0 and nag-enter siya ng length ng side B which is 12. So, square root of the square root is the power of A, so A times 2.0 plus B times 2.0. Kaya siya ng A, 13. Okay. Ito siya. Natin yung kanyang solution. Kaya. So, the following statement taken from the code is in 3.8. Calculate the square root of the sum of the squares of the triangles of both two sides. So, C is plus the square root of power A, 2.0 plus R. So, notice that the following mathematical expression is used as the squared functions argument. So, power A, 2.0 plus power B, 2.0. So, the expression calls the power function twice. So, once to calculate the square root of A and again to calculate the square root of B. So, these two squares are then added together and the sum is sent to the square root function. So, parang ano lang to, nagmamath ng talaga kayo. Yun nga lang, mas pinahirap kasi sa code, meron tayo mathematical functions, meron lang tayo code things. So, yeah. So, in random number naman, a value that is chosen from a set of values. So, each value in the set has an equal likelihood of being chosen. So, we have to use the CSD DLAB header files. Use time to generate different seed values each time that the program runs. Sharp include seed time. So, this is needed for time. So, unsigned seed is equal to time 0, S1, random numbers, or unsigned seed, yung type. Random numbers can be scaled to a range. So, int max is equal to 6. Int num is equal to random number, modulus max plus 1. So, getting random numbers, try nyo itong e-code sa DevC or sa mga cellphones kung ano ang magiging output. So, getting random numbers, returns a random number between 0 and the largest int in the computer holds. So, ikaw lang set ka ng int maximum to 6. So, we'll yield the same sequence of numbers each time the program is run. So, it initializes random number generator. Yung srandomum, it initializes the random number generator with unsigned int x.x is the seed value. So, this should be called at most once in a program. So, that's the end of the lesson. And if you have any questions, just PM me. And our examination will be at the end of this month, probably. So we will be reminding you for our exam. So I will be posting this to our Google Classroom. And thank you so much.